My mind works. Hey, Paul.
I thought we would demonstrate the difference between two-way communications and one-way communications that we have with Zelda. Over. Yeah. So the problem with Zello is when you key up and you talk, especially if there's a delayed show, you can't hear what the other person is saying while you're talking. Or with Skype, you can talk back and forth easily. And I'm trying to explain that to a few people that are coming to me in private messages now.
So that was very annoying. That was very annoying that Johnny talked over. Good if I'm at the lunch or walking outside.
Experimentation purposes on the current chart that's already there to say, okay, if we tweak this number just a little bit or this number just a little bit and then hit refresh, see where those dots land.
Yeah.
And you know what I mean? And then look at the day before and see if it was kind of in that mode. You know what I mean? It was a little bit more suited for that setting. And then going, it may be something as simple as we just need to tweak some of the, I mean, it might be worth
it. I don't think you need to tweak anything. It's just that the certain market conditions you have to recognize, you know.
Well, that's always going to be the case. Even if you can tweak it for today and make it look better tomorrow,
different market,
it might
you
be
know.
All else. It's always never going to be perfect. I know.
There you go, talking negative about it again.
Yeah, I can't help it.
Brilliant, Richard. That's really.
I'm up $540 this week off of it.
You know what?
Why not? You can't do any better than that.
Well, where's Carl? I don't know. I'm ready, man.
All right. I'm still watching this PSA. I want to go on record to say, watch this PSA. I think we pop on this. I almost want to take a bigger gamble on this.
What do you want to do then?
Just, you know, put it out there. But a good show overall. I mean, I enjoyed listening to it. I was here. I didn't get working on the tradometer page yet, but I want to do that right after the market.
So you want to do it on the platform you have?
No, I mean, did you get anything? I mean, do you have anything to show me?
No, just some holes in my drywall.
No, then I'll put together, you know, that thing we were talking about. Just to get, I want to get it going. All right, we'll talk more about that.
Yeah, I know we want to get the new tickers going, too. I got going on those.
You just work on that, you know, and I'll work on that.
Letter C, City, raises base rate. Citibank said it has raised its base lending rate to 3.75% with 0.5% effective Thursday. That's letter C.
But my internet going all crazy and ran for a couple of weeks. Now, it is like, one of the biggest stresses I've ever had. Because I rely on it for for the show, but also, too, just to manage things.
At the high now, 110, 30 up 30 cents.
Well, the outside world, it's just got in my head.
As Gerald says, you vote against the sale.
Anyway, it seems to be. But so it's cut off a lot of my stress, and overall total outage probably only been 3 or 4 hours in the last 2 weeks. But it's caused a lot of it's caused me to not be able to get some certainly some of my extra responsibilities that I'd like to take care of, like the trader meter and stuff. It's made it hard to do. I was up to about 2 o'clock this morning in here working on it. But then I looked overnight and went out again. I hope this never happens to you.
Whatever. You know, I understand. I'm not giving you any issues about it. It's what it is. I just wish you'd think that if something was wrong affecting your business, they would be more proactive in fixing it than if you're paying the customer. Apparently, you're not.
Yeah. Well, you would think the whole county is blinking. You would think that they
good thing these computers are not hooked up to someone's life support system.
Yeah, well, they are hooked to alarm systems. The alarm companies like posting all over Facebook that you know they're looking for an alternative, and there is no alternative out here. The telephone company's point is that when they go and look at it, everything's fine. Everything's operational. What they don't realize is it's going out for like 10 minutes at a time. And then it'll work again for another 2 hours and go out for another 10 minutes, and that's where it's very aggravating. So from their standpoint, they're just lucky that the things, you know, pass the traffic, I guess. You know what I mean? But in a practical sense, it's very aggravating to be sitting there going, page not found all over again, and I'll lose your show. And then, or if I'm broadcasting, mine goes out. It's just, in a practical sense, it's extremely frustrating. And Johnny, I have done everything. I have switched out my equipment twice. I mean, I got $700 worth of stuff I got to send back to Amazon. I switched out everything.
But you knew where the problem was, right?
I knew that, and I showed them graphs of it and stuff, and they were like, man, the power supplies aren't quite right or something. can't do anything about it. It's the way the gods are aligned right now. You know, the planets are aligned right now. I've been at it proactive trying to fix it.
Breaking down.
But Johnny, this is a great song you're playing right now.
What was I playing? I don't even know. What was I playing? I apologize.
AJG, Arthur J. Gallagher acquires MW Magnol Company. Alpha, Julia Golf.
It's 3 o'clock already. We're at the lows of the session.
Hey, John, we did a trading meter long signal here. I missed it, though. I was thinking about taking it. I hesitated.
Oh, yeah.
What do you think at this level?
At 3 o'clock going to the last hour at the lows of the session. You know, the tradeometer is a hard thing to pass up. It's already bounced pretty. It's already bounced 2 points off the lows there. Came down to the S1 pivot. Was it a divergence? It's already bounced. not 50 points, 20 points to get back to the highs. Not that I'm calling a run back to the highs in the last hour. But you know, any type of tradeometer setup is always is probably better than anything. Did we get any...
K-Rod saying that boat's already set.
XOM, Exxon Mobil, Rich Tillerson to retire down with elected chairman and CEO.
That's the hard thing. You get a trigger, you got to be on top of it. The trade armor will give you that spot, but you have to get through the mental... case that, hey, are you chasing this? Is that made a rotation? Normally, the strategy would call for a rotation exit. That brings it up back above that 80. But what if we see this and stay embedded? You know, it stands up being under the bearish flag.
Giving a Vex's 12-month price target of $9, 24-month price target of $5.
They're just they're allowed to come on and manipulate the markets like that. Oh, great.
A Vex's off below at 46.30.